Hello and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials! My name is Errol and we are going through a series of videos on campaigns! In this tutorial, we are going to create and edit a campaign. In Method CRM, you will find the Campaigns tab at the top, and when you click it, you will see the New Campaign tab link, or even the New Campaign button. Let's create a campaign! And it automatically chooses me as the one the campaign is assigned to. Haha, smart campaign. You can change that to one of your other users on Method. For example, I can change the owner to May if need be. But I'm not going to do that. Next is the campaign name, and it's a required field. It is in your best interest to type in a name that is descriptive and not random names because you are too lazy. Huh, names are hard. Let's make this a poster campaign to promote an event I'm running. The next is type. What kind of campaign is it? You can see a number of types listed here, but if you want to make your own type, you can hit the Add New or the wonderful three-dot ellipsis button. Here you can create, edit, or delete campaign types. Thing is, I don't need a new type, so I'll just cancel close this. And for type, I will choose advertisement. Under status, you can choose a number of options. And with the ellipsis button again, you can create different statuses as well. I'll just stick with planned status for now. Let's put a description in here. I want to make some posters and hang them about the city. Under planning info, it wants all these details. Let's put in a start and end date. Total send can be used for a number of things. For example, the posters I'm sending out. I'm gonna make 1,000 posters. Expected response. Oh, I hope everybody will come. That's not gonna happen. Let's just put in 20%. Expected revenue. My event is charging $10 a person and it can hold about 100 people. Let's put in $1,000. Budgeted cost. Hopefully $100 for the posters. I promised the band half the revenue because I believe in supporting the arts. That's after expenses, so let's give them $500 for expenses. And the venue is giving us the place for free as long as people buy drinks! Woohoo! Before we save this, let's take a look at more actions. You can clear this whole form, which I won't do. You can delete the campaign, which I'm just starting it, so I'm not going to do that. And you can spell check your description. Personally, I just ask Alex, the documentation guy, and he picks apart my grammar all the time. Okay, let's save and edit our new campaign. Ta-da! Now we're editing the campaign. And look, at the bottom are all sorts of new and exciting things. We have stats! Statistics! I love statistics. I mean, I really do. Of course, there aren't any statistics because this is a new campaign. Sadness. Oh well, as soon as leads and opportunities start coming in, you will see all these wonderful statistics start to fill in, and you can recalculate them. And all sorts of fun things. Maybe you can even make a graph in Excel or something. The other sections are as the title indicates. Any contacts you associated with this campaign will be listed here. Of course, I don't have any contacts here. But if I were to go into any customer, you will see that each has an additional info section where you have a place to put in the campaign for a lead or customer. In fact, activities, opportunities, estimates, and invoices all have a field to associate a campaign to it. And note, in each section, they have a button which allows you to create either an activity, an opportunity, an estimate, or an invoice. So if I were to add a new estimate from here, you can find the campaign field down here, and it's already filled in with our new campaign. And that's pretty much the basics for creating and editing a campaign. Join us in our next videos on campaigns as we talk about List Builder. Once again, if you have any questions, please leave them in the YouTube comments or you can tweet us @MethodCRM. I hope you have a great day and take care. Bye-bye.